Come on. No, we're going the wrong way. This is not good. No, why are we going back down? Oh God, we're going the wrong way. Come on. Why are we going down? Yeah, landing this thing's going to be slightly more tricky. Okay, welcome back everybody. This is Space Engineers Permadeath Survival, and we're picking up where we left off on the last episode. Now this is a good opportunity to have a look around. There's a possibility that that could be the Earth-like planet. Well, that's definitely the sun. Home base is over there. We drifted a little bit off, so yeah, we definitely came in at a bit of an angle at first. That might be why we struggled. That's the safe zone. I'm surprised we can see it from here. Now you can see the distance we had to travel to the magnesium hole and where the cobalt we found was. It's quite a fairly long way. So there's enemy bases around that area there. There's enemy bases somewhere around our base as well, within a few kilometers, probably like in that ring somewhere. Definitely a risky situation. Right, so one thing we definitely don't want to do right now is get out of our seat. Because if we get out of our seat, we'll probably end up floating. Now, luckily within this thing, I should be able to... In fact, actually, we're going to do a quick test of this. Get out of my seat. Okay, so mag plates on is default. Got a nice little viewing hole there. Right, so... all detectors on. Let's make sure our range is up. 300 meters. Downside to being small grid, but... should be fine with all detectors plus on. What's our antenna set to? 5,000 meters. I don't think it needs to be that far. See, it's got to be far enough so that if I get a drift, I've got time to grab the antenna and connect into the remote control and bring the ship back. That'll do. Show ship name. Have we given the ship its name? No. It's called the Hopper, but it's in space now, so it's the Space Hopper. For any of those 80s kids out there who probably remember Space Hoppers. Yeah. So, right. The last thing I want to do is get out. That would be tragic, because then I would be end up, like, drifting away from this thing. And I would end up needing the emergency situation, and I don't really want to have to go down that route. If we want to get off onto a rock, we need to make sure that we're parked up dead flush against the surface that we can step onto. Right, so let's have a look. We've got plenty of fuel. Let's check our ice situation. Always be extra cautious about these things. How much ice do we actually have? Yeah, we've got a fair amount of ice left. I think we've got enough to use a full tank up. I'm going to actually turn off the O2 gens. Oops. Put that there. Toggle on off. We're going to turn them off for now so that we've got that reserve that stays there. Oxygen, we'll have to pop it on every now and again just to refuel our oxygen in here. But generally speaking, I think we should be pretty safe. Then we get a better idea of our actual fuel consumption. Right, now we need to pick a target to go and visit. So I think we go for... don't want to stray too far away, but... home base was kind of in that direction, so we're going to go for... let's say that one. That's as good as any. So we're just going to aim slightly off-center. And get some speed. I'm not going to go hell for leather, because for every meter per second that we put on, we have to burn that to take it off again. And as you saw there, it used maybe 1% of our fuel, maybe a bit less. It's gone down to 99%, it's not 100 anymore. So now we just have to wait while we drift. Drifty McDrifterson all the way over to this asteroid in space. I can't give you any nice third person views because we've got that turned off. Now, what I'm hoping to find, and mark is any source of ice, because we are limited on the surface. So any source of ice that we could mine, and we could send a drone up to do the mining potentially. This is more of an expedition mission, marking, GPSing. So any ice, any silver. We're not going to find platinum, that's only on Mars. We're not going to find uranium, because that's only on the alien planet. Any magnesium, cobalt, the stuff that we're finding hard to get on the ground right now. All useful. Right, we're going to start just bleeding off a little bit of speed. Now, I'm not going to do all of this with dampeners on. I'll only use that when I need to stop. Now, because we've only got 300 meter range on our ore detector, we may have to do a bit of a loop around this. I want to stay on the light side if I can. So we're going to aim kind of near the surface here. I'm going to do a real slow pass, so we've got plenty of time to get close and do any detection. Now, this thing's probably like a kilometer across, so we might need to do a little bit of traveling around. It may even have nothing on it. So with the AQD vanilla ore distribution mod that we've got in, what that does is it means that asteroids can only contain the basic materials, silver, and that's it, basic materials and silver. So we've got iron, we've got ice on this one, so we just need to find that ice deposit, and then we can mark it, ready for... And see, I'm wondering something, would drones be able to see the GPS points? I'm assuming they would. You could certainly tell a drone to go to a GPS point. So we could, what we could do is like pre-send a drone up, then trigger it onto like go to GPS point. It will find its way there, hopefully without destroying itself. Got our lights on. And then we could take over and manually control it. Or we could build a manned vessel and just have the fun of actually mining it in with the real danger involved. There's our ice. So we're going to literally put a GPS point right in front of the ice deposit. And I'm doing all of this with dampeners off because it saves fuel. It's only when I really need to stop that I'll probably put the dampeners on just to make sure that we're 100% stopped. So this is kind of closer to how like NASA would actually fly a shuttle, just like pulses. And that's close enough. Right, slash GPS, ice, asteroid. Just so we can differentiate it in our bar. Ooh, a little bit of a jolt there. There's our reflection, hello. Okay, so we've got an ice one there. Do we need any ice right now? Could we possibly mine some of that from the doorway? I don't like the chances because of the sides of the wings on this thing. Yeah, I don't really want to get too close to that. Probably never get back in. Right, so this is iron and ice. We don't really need iron in space, so we're not going to worry too much about that one now. So that's one done. Where's our planet? Let's always get our orientation back so we don't go too far away from it. And we are going to go to... Where's a good target next? I'm curious about... I wonder if that's part of the same cluster. Now, there is a possibility of a cert popping up in space. They're more likely to be here. We're also likely to see like the old cargo ship fly by. We've got to be careful to stay away from them. They're not overly aggressive naturally, but you know, they can be a pain. And we might get space pirates as well. Again, if we stay out of their way, they're generally okay. Sometimes though, you've got no choice. In fact, there is something there that's sort of sparkling right in between my crosshair. I wonder if it's just pixels, but I should have put a front camera on here so we've got zoom. Right, my food situation's starting to creep down a little bit. We do have the food and water in our inventory. I'm actually going to put these in the seat because I want to use the synth food first, really. I'm going to put noms on my seat, actually. I don't think we have to put it in the square brackets, but it should just work. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, we've got our bonus water there, and I'm going to put like one of these in my thing so we eat that. I think I can see something there. It could just be a hole. I've got an idea. I've got no ammo, but it does have, there we are. It does have zoom capability. Yeah, it's nothing over there. I would argue the zoom on these is better than the zoom on the cameras. So we do have a front view via that. It's just not guaranteed to always be at the front. There's another asteroid over there that looks quite interesting, and there's these ones over here, but these are likely to be parts of this cluster. So they'll probably share the same ore distribution. Right, where are we coming in at? We're not aiming to miss right now, so we're going to slow down a bit. Luckily, this thing's fairly maneuverable. I can actually turn off my Atmos and save some fuel. We just save some energy. We just need to make absolutely sure that we remember to turn them on when we come back for re-entry. Again, I want to stay on the light side if I can. We've got like some mods in that darken things up. Our skybox mod actually includes the equivalent of like Darkness Divine or Space Just Got Real. So it makes shadows super dark. Not like insanely, impossibly dark, but dark enough to be a problem in space. Right, what do we think we're getting on this little lucky dip? It's like a little gamble every time. You go to one of these, you don't know what you're gonna get. Could be a complete dud, it could be something you've already got. Could hit a jackpot. Right, nice close pass around its waist. Hopefully we should get close enough to detect something if it's there. Now we've got our lights on. Now that we're close enough, we should be able to... Yeah, lights are on. Should be able to react to anything. Got silver. Let's use our stronger thrusters here. Let's come back round. See if we can get to where we saw that silver. There's the silver marker. Now we just need to track down where it is. It could be inside the asteroid, so again, that would help determine what we need equipment-wise to drill it. Because if it's deep in the asteroid and I went and just stuck like one drill on this thing, it's not going to work. Not very easily anyway. Space Pirate Mayday, we're not going to go anywhere near that. That's that sparkly dot there. Right, I'm not sure where the silver actually is. I think it is inside somewhere, but sometimes they're in like a little crevice. 200 meters away. In that direction. I don't see an easy way to it. going to complete an orbit of this thing just to... See, and not using dampeners, so basically not constantly burning our fuel to turn and stuff. It's making things a lot more efficient. We've got our O2 gen turned off and we've only used 4% fuel in this time. And we're basically maintaining reasonable distance from the asteroid. Okay, it gets a bit closer here, so maybe just something. Watch our speed a little bit. Okay, the marker moved. As you get closer, sometimes it gets a bit more accurate. Or it detects an alternate deposit. Okay, I think it's right there in this little nook, just after this bit here. It's worth taking the time to do a bit of an orbit. There it is. There's our silver. I wonder, I probably can get close to that one. I'm just going to stop, mark it. Asteroid. Silver asteroid rather than hemorrhoid. I didn't actually just say that. Right, so we're going to GPS off again and we're just going to very carefully... Oh, dampeners off, come on. Just going to very carefully try to approach this. Now, again, I don't have much in the way of a view here, so we're going to sort of do that. And hope for the best. We're going to go super slow. So I want to get close enough to to try and mine it, but from the doorway without actually exiting the ship, just to take a little bit back with us. But I don't want to risk crashing our engines. Right, hang on. That's where our doorway is. Now these back thrusters are quite powerful, so it's like gentle taps. Our O2 is low right now, but that's fine. I'm gonna be opening the door soon anyway, so we'll grab our O2 tank for that. Come on. We're 15 meters away from it there. I'm 15 meters away from it. I think I can stop it there. And then gently turn it. Just to try and get our doorway kind of over it. Bear in mind I'm looking backwards here, so... Very, very slowly approach it. That's about as close as we can get, I think. I'm just going to grab my oxygen tank. Well, we can put that back for now. Let's get rid of our rubbish from here, just in case. I think I've got room in a cargo container somewhere for the rest of the junk that we're carrying. Get rid of those. Get rid of those. It's just these are too big. Yeah, it should be good enough, I think. Let's just see what situation we've got here. Now this is where like the realistic sound is awesome. We're 14 meters away, but the engine's kind of in the way there, so I need to back it up a little bit and then, yeah, bring it in a bit more. So let's back that up a touch. Just a skosh. Too far. It's going to be pretty damn close. I should possibly put a little ramp out there. Engines are still on and they're on dampeners, so it should counter anything I do to this right now. I am carrying a few. The way the realistic sound mode works is like you can only hear what's actually like vibrating through your suit. Did we get 387 silver? Pop that in there somewhere. Any room to stash that anywhere? Now, if I come unstuck from this ship, I will be in deep trouble. Right, I mean, I could technically sort of just dive out there, land on that surface, and then hopefully jump back into here. But if I bounce off and fail to lock with my boots, then I could end up floating around and not able to reach a seat, or then I'm having to sort of remote control that thing while I'm floating around and hopefully catch myself. Bit nasty. Okay, how much have I got this time? Another 57. 400 of the stuff. Okay, maybe I can scooch myself around a little bit more. Oh, that works. Okay. Yeah, that puts that practically in the doorway. Be careful to catch everything that comes off. Oof. Be aware that I might jitter off the platform. What's that? Cert division transport. It's getting closer. I'm going to turn my antenna off, actually. I've just got to be careful not to fall out of the ship. How much have I got now? Another 500. I think that's enough as a little sample to play with. Yeah. Should be enough. Is that still getting closer? Okay, oxygen's starting to get a little bit low now, so that's going to replenish. Let's turn our O2 gem back on just to fill this thing with oxygen. And back off again. Right. So, have we marked this one? I believe we have. Yeah, this thing is getting closer. We're going to have to start moving away from it. Right, so we found the two things we really wanted to find. So now we need to evade the enemy. And consider getting closer to where we need to start making markers. So we might start getting into gravity very soon, so we have to keep an eye on that. That thing's not going to want to enter gravity, I don't think. Right, we're going to stop here and just keep an eye on where it's going. Still coming towards us for sure, certain, yeah. I'm going to go over that way. Right, we are very close to where the gravity starts, so we need to be very aware and keep an eye on it while we try to stop that thing from getting too close to us. Have a look at how big it is. It's not too big. It's a heavy transport though. It could call for help if we get too close to it ourselves. And we have no ammo ourselves. But yeah, we're just hoping that this thing sort of scooches past and doesn't notice us. Otherwise we might need some evasive action. It's kind of going at an angle. I have no third person view, so like it makes kind of navigation a little bit tricky, but I think we're probably okay. 5.9655. I think it's going to come pretty damn close. We might need to move. Let's go that way. Leave dampeners off for a minute. It's generally clear in that direction. We have to be very careful not to drift into atmosphere, so let's keep an eye on that atmospheric number. And just watch this thing. So we've marked an ice asteroid and a silver asteroid, so that's like part of our mission done. Our main mission for getting into space was to mark some enemy bases so that we can do missile launches from just inside gravity. We're going to have to do that as efficiently as we can so we don't run out of both hydrogen and ice before we actually complete it and get landed again. I don't really want to have to ditch this craft. We are carrying a little bit of silver that we managed to mine from the doorway of the craft. We're going to need a more dedicated miner to handle it properly. 602. I think we're starting to get towards equilibrium here. When that number starts like staying still and not going down anymore, then it's as close as it's going to get, and it should start going back up again, and then from that point we know we're safe as long as we don't approach it. But if it gets too close and spots us, it could call drones, and then we're going to have to do a runner. Luckily it's here, we can get up to speed pretty fast. The maximum speed limit will help stop a drone from finding us, but we've just got to then hope we don't have to make too many maneuvers to avoid asteroids before we run out of fuel or before they give up. Okay, I think 5.94 is the closest approach. We may be okay. It should start getting to 5.95 again soon. Slightly tense moment here, and I have to be aware that something else could spawn in the meantime while we're waiting for this to pass, like whatever that was. I think it's one of those random intermittent signals. We don't have to worry about it. 5.95. Okay, we are clear. We've got our antenna turned off as well. Personal antenna's on, but it's got such a short range it doesn't matter. Yeah, the next part of our mission is to try and get the enemy bases marked, but we've got a problem. As soon as you get out of range of them, like from here, the markers all disappeared. which is nice. Right, our friend's gone. So we're just going to start drifting in towards home, I think, until we start seeing these enemies pop up. And then we can make a decision as to whether we can hold ourselves steady in the atmosphere. Now we're overshooting, so we're aiming for an overshoot above home, because gravity's going to grab us and we don't really want to have to make any corrections. So we're aiming way over, like about there. Because as soon as gravity does grab us, it's going to start pulling us down. And our little marker thing is going to start coming down towards home. I'm looking at the circle with the cross in it that's to the right hand side of our toolbar. Landing this thing is going to be a tricky one. I can't show you a third person view. So yeah, the configuration of this ship, for those that missed the last few episodes, and I honestly think you should watch them, but it's mostly small thrusters with a couple of large atmospherics to catch it on landing, and per time gravity, it was really difficult to get away from it, so we may end up having to sort of tail down all the way to the last minute when the atmos can then catch us. And sort of suicide burn it on the way in and hope that we can stop in time. This thing has no parachutes. I think we might end up overshooting the gravity well. Alright, I'm gonna bring us back in. I think we missed it. Oh! Don't want to press F. Kind of wish this had a slightly lower seating position so I could see that while I'm flying. It's kind of an either or at the moment. Coming over a bit far to the left here. So, corrected burn. Should probably turn my atmos on just to be safe. Right, we're 11k's up. We've now got... Okay, now we're starting to see... enemies. That's probably one of the ones that's... Right, there's one over here that's definitely a problem. So we need to keep an eye on fuel use and just make a decision as to whether fuel use is going to be a problem. Might not be able to mark all of them on this one trip. Ugh. If we can get two marked, I'll call that a bit of a win. Right, that's one. The next one's over that direction. So let's get out of here and get straight again. This is what I'm talking about with, like, getting the attitude and, you know, the role and everything correct before you mark. So potentially what we may need to do is have some amount of manual control over these missiles on the way down. At some point we'll need to make a decision about going home. I think after this one. I don't think I'm going to get them all marked before we run out of fuel. Right. We've run out of... Well, we've lost our attitude indicator. Have to lose a bit of altitude here. Try and gain that attitude indicator back. Kind of odd when sometimes it just disappears like that. We should definitely have it. Okay, so I've got a feeling I'm not going to be able to. Maybe if I get out of the ship and get back into the cockpit. No? Marvellous. I have no idea which way I'm facing in relation to gravity. Oh, I can use the little ball thing at the bottom. Very accurate. But we can get close enough and then do some manual tweaking on the way down with the missile itself. As long as we get to a decent launch point. That's a double. So I think we have to drop in the middle of the two. Right, let's get to a good position where I can come to home now. We're using a lot more fuel than we want to here, so... Want a ballistic trajectory down to home and then sort of catch it before we land. I hope I don't screw it up. Atmos are on, so. I think we need probably 2 kilometers to fully stop. We're going to play it a little bit safer. Come on, all I have to do is stop. Atmos are kicking in. Hydrogen, use the hydrogen. Nearly. That's one way of landing. Right, let's turn it all off. And then inspect the damage. We're kind of sideways halfway up a mountain somewhere, but... first thing I want to do is take our silver. So we might not be able to fly this back out. Maybe we can. Let's have a look. Let's have a try. Let's see if we can fly this thing. So, Atmos. Why is it trying to roll over? Right, okay, so we're up. We might have lost our forward thrusters. Yeah, we definitely need a craft with better thrust on the bottom. I see potential for an ice well around here. Let's park ourselves somewhere around here. See what the damage was. Surprisingly, not too bad. We lost a couple of thrusters on the back and damaged these. So it definitely needs some thrusters on these blocks for going up. And it probably needs a couple more Atmos in, maybe. I think we wouldn't have needed the Atmos so much if we had the hydrogens. Let's fix this thing at least. Right, let's get this thing fixed and drop off our silver so we can get fined. Dump all that in there, dump. Yeah, that wasn't too bad actually, given that I dropped it. I think we've managed to just slow down enough to not like completely destroy the thing at the last minute. So it needs a couple of... okay, even that's not damaged. Right, so it needs a couple of large hydros on the back.
Meteor storm inbound.
No, you can't be meteor storming on me. Holy crap, that looks so massive. Let's go back to the old fashioned ones. I think we got away with that. not having third person really makes it difficult. Yeah, this thing survived reasonably well. We could, like I said, we could do a couple more of them on the bottom here. Will they fit, for that matter? It might fit. Okay. Will it be so kind on that side? Yeah. Okay, we're gonna have to be extra careful landing it. No, we're missing a sting. Single steel plate, even though it said that I had everything. Gotta keep my eyes open for spiders. I thought I got steel plates. Silly thing. Come on. Okay. We could put more on the bottom of these bits here. We could put some more side thrust in. There's plenty of room to upgrade even further. That kind of prevents the need for us to use these to get up, which is easier if we can stay level. It is a bit of a risk having all of the thrust at the back like this, but oh, we could put a couple more on there and there. Do you know what? I'm going to do that. Plenty of thrust. I mean, we're just gonna have to be gentle with it, but we could always group these slightly separately so these can be turned off. Right, we're gonna clear that and put these back on the bar again, because that's why it's always been a bit weird before. I'm gonna turn that off as well. We have to remember to group all these. And what we may need to do is like set up just like a Mavs group, so we can turn all the thrusters off and just turn on some small like low speed Mavs to navigate with in space without burning all our fuel. Okay, and I think forward thrust, I think that's plenty, especially for space. Up thrust, that's more than enough. I think with the extra thrust, we could probably stick another cargo in there. Do away with our little hole. These are not good enough. Was trying to mine with that the way it is just doesn't work. This just gives us the means to get a little bit closer to surfaces to mine them from the ship without falling off. We still need to put the ramp on though. It looks silly, but it does the job. See, now I can stand like almost level with these to do mining so we can get a lot closer. Good. Right. Fuel wise, this is going to need to refuel. Where did we leave it? Where's it? Where's the fuel situation right now? So let's switch this back on. 85% fuel. Let's turn these back on. Let's see if we've still got any ice in the system to make more fuel, because we did burn a lot while we were actually sort of potting around trying to mark some markers. I'm not sure it's the best strategy now, but yeah, we didn't do too bad on ice. We could probably do it filling more up. I did spot an ice marker over in that direction on the way back in. Jesus, all those reds. scary. Yeah, there's an ice market somewhere around there. We could possibly build a large rig to mine that out. Right, so let's do this grouping up now. Hydrogen, so I really wanna, okay, that's the H thrust, so we need to add that one, that one, that one, and that one to the group. Turn them on, turn them off, just to make sure they're off. There we go. We must have had one out of sync with the rest of the group. Turn it off, save power. We're at 92% hydrogen right now. We're definitely going to need more. Oh, actually, no. I need to get the hydrogen full up. Then I know where we're at. Okay, so we're at 100% now. So I can kill the generators and check our ice. 2K, 1K, 1K. We used most of what we had in that whole trip, so turn this off. Don't like how close that is. We need to get some ammo in this thing as well, so we might as well grab some while we're here and remembering it. So, Gatling, let's see. Why do some of these only have one in them? They should be replenishing. I'm just going to take four of them. I'll take another four from that one. 8 boxes of ammunition. I'm going to put them straight into the Gatling turret. I need an in to... We have to put him in the back there, I think. Really? Are we supposed to... Have we damaged the Gatling turret pipe? Oh, do you know what? I know why. I'm a moron. Yeah, I'm an absolute idiot. Right. Let's find the cargo container that we can put the rest of these in. There we go. Turn it off so it doesn't start shooting things. Okay. So we have a drop point over there. We have a drop point there. That should be, that's near enough over there. That's near enough over there. We will have to manually do some guidance on the way down. There's our silver asteroids up there. Our ice asteroids there. They're both within decent reach. I'm loving that. That was pretty cool. I'm going to take a screenshot. That's the situation we're in right now. We've got some preparation done. We've got a bunch more to put in over there. I think it's going to be harder than we thought because the fuel capacity on this thing. Landing was a problem, but I think we've solved that now. We've got plenty of thrust. Did I hear something? Why is our elevator down? Oh, because we flew out. Okay. This is one of the situations where we can call the elevator. I don't know why I keep going through the door. Right. So, I think we're in a pretty decent position right now. I'm going to actually go down to zero. Yeah. Next time... What we're going to be doing is marking up those other two, well, those other one, two, three, maybe, probably three. Yeah, probably going to try and mark up the overpasses for these. And then we can start looking at working out how to build these missiles. It's going to be an interesting one. I have no idea how I'm approaching the build for those yet. So you just wish me luck. And yeah, we will catch you. Next, where am I going to put myself? I need to be up on one. False ending. Huh. Real ending now. Bye.